After always looking for the right highway peg, whether too cheap and always failing, or too expensive to justify, we at AltRider have found the perfect solution right in between. So we're gonna get ready to do and demonstrate one installation. You guys, same application and instructions across the 22 millimeter, the 25 millimeter,
27 millimeter, and 32 millimeter, or the inch equivalent of 7/8, 1 inch, 1 1/8, and 1 1/4.
So let's take a look at the kit contents. Inside of the package, you're gonna receive your two peg bodies. They'll already have the spring detents, and notice that we went ahead and set two so we get that really strong engagement.
The two clevis bodies, four stainless steel plates that are inserted into the clevis bodies. These have a specific orientation, and we'll discuss that in a moment.
The two M5 stainless steel dowels. You'll have four of your M6 nylock nuts, your M6 screws, your M5 pivoting screws, flatheads, and then here are the clamp bodies. These specifically are 1 1/4. They'll either be 1 inch or 1 1/4.
If you order the 22 millimeter or 7/8 size, you'll receive a 1 inch clamp with a gasket, and the 27 millimeter or the 1 1/8 will come with the same gasket but with the 1.25 inch clamp. Tools required. We just need a 4 millimeter Allen and a 5 millimeter Allen. I've got it set up on an extension and a ratchet. When you order direct from AltRider, you'll receive resealable thread locker.
The other solutions though that we picked was being able to get your highway peg to deploy at just the right position based upon all of the different setups you have and different bar assemblies on the different motorcycles that they're gonna go on. And we did this with a really ingenious, simple solution. We have four positions milled into the stainless steel clamp and six positions milled into the clevis, which yields 24 positions possible when installed that rotates every 15 degrees all the way around. We're gonna do a dry fit real quick so that we can pick what position we wanna put this on.
On the clevis, I have one side that is recessed for the shouldered fastener and one side that's threaded. Grab two of your stainless steel plates, and we need to first orientate them correctly. Place the plate in the clevis. You'll need to make sure it's sitting on the correct edge of the plate and that it's not sitting higher than the clevis as shown. The plate should be flush with the clevis. It's easiest to run your finger over the clevis to make sure it's sitting flush with the stainless steel plate. If it's positioned incorrectly, flip the plate to the other side. Be sure to remember how these two plates are now orientated. Once you have the two plates orientated, put them on either side of the peg body with the large hole lined up with the hole on the peg body. And one of the small holes should go over the ball detents with the smaller hole on the bottom of the peg where the logo is. Then squeeze the two plates together so they fit into the clevis and slide them in. When you pivot the pegs back and forth, the steel plates should remain stationary. If the plates move when the peg is pivoted, you've got them orientated incorrectly.
Again, guys, there's my recess, so I want to start my screw on that side. And then I'm just gonna get this guy just started because I wanna set this up on my dry run to decide which position I want. I'm gonna have to disassemble this one last time to put it together after I pick what pin location I'd like. One of the first things of the installation is we're gonna wanna take our time and mock up to determine where do we wanna put the clamp body. Sometimes you've got a lot of aspects going on with the motorcycle, such as do I have headlights, do I have other auxiliary lights, do I need to get around exhaust? So you've got a lot of adjustability. Before we even get the peg on there is, hey, where do I want to put the clamp? Where do I want this position?
As part of the dry fit to find out where you want to put your highway pegs on your motorcycle, sit on the bike and ensure you have a location on your bars that your feet can rest comfortably. You'll need enough straight section on your bar to ensure that the clamp can secure successfully, and be aware that the pegs deploy perpendicular to your bars.
I'm gonna set this thing pretty much perpendicular to the ground or parallel to the ground. We've taken our time to determine where on the crash bar do I want the actual clamp, and then now I get to decide where and what position do I want my peg to actually drop out at. And I think I actually like this angle right around here. So I've identified this pin location into this pin location here. So now I'm gonna disassemble the clamp and note that this is how I'm gonna assemble it. There's that location I had selected here. So I'm gonna marry that up to there. Now I'm ready for my M8 fastener. But now I wanna take a moment and go ahead and apply Loctite to my M8.
Be sure to liberally add thread locker, as the engine sends a lot of vibration through the pegs and you don't want to lose your pegs.
And then this is where I need my M5 Allen driver. You can feel that lock in there now, that's totally locked. I'm gonna torque that down after I get it onto the bike so that it holds it for me. So I'm gonna grab my other clamp body half and position my logo correctly. You have the option to run this through either side. I can run it through that side or I can run it through this side because both sides will capture that nut. You see that casting on there. Me personally, I like to actually put the bolts in, and what that does is it just leaves the nylock assembly set into the inside of the bike where it's less noticeable. I'm gonna get that side just started. I'm gonna do the same for the bottom. And when I do this, guys, I get that started. And then with my finger, that's all I need because I'm going to let the casting capture that nut and it holds it for me. I don't need an actual wrench on the other side. So I'm gonna get those going. Now I'm gonna go ahead and torque evenly. Watch my spacing here and I'm gonna just rotate and compress evenly from both sides. Before I put my peg body in, now I can do my final torque on my flathead. If you ordered the 22 millimeter
or 27 millimeter,
you're gonna receive the rubber gasket. Go ahead and run it like this. It comes long. You can overlap it, and which gives you a tremendous amount of clamping force.
Or you can trim it a bit if there's too much material. Just be sure to trim a small amount of material at a time, as you want the most friction you can accomplish with the clamp, and the rubber material will compress more than you realize.
Go ahead and snug that up, and then you're gonna wanna set the clamp body on there, using that to hold your clamp or your gasket. Then go ahead and set the other clamp half on. Go ahead and set your screw through. Obviously it's a lot easier when it's on the bike. Just as before, I'll get those started. Again, guys, I only need to use my fingers to hold that guy in there. Again, what I wanna do is creating equidistance between the gaps and compression, and I'll slowly walk this together as I reach my final torque value. And then you have that gasket in there that's gonna prevent any clocking or spinning on the 22 millimeter. As you guys will notice in the kit, you have inverse logo treatment, and that's because when this is up, this is the bottom side, right? So this is all traction for me, this is it retracted. And so I wanted to make sure I grabbed the right logo.
Add the stainless steel plates and make sure they're orientated correctly as previously discussed. Add several drops of thread locker to the shoulder bolt.
And then, guys, you're gonna wanna torque that down. You'll feel that snug up. Okay, but while we're here, just to show you all the many different possible configurations, let's go ahead and just show you one other possible way. There's many different ways you could set it up, but on this one, might want the peg body to be in line with the tube. Took a few minutes out of all the different positions and actually were able to get it directly in line with crash bars assembly right there. Lots of different options, guys. Take your time, enjoy it. You've got 24 different positions and 360 degrees all the way around. Really excited to bring these to market. It's been a long time and I know there's a need for this. Glad to bring the solution. Let us know if you have any questions and check in with us at AltRider.com.